Hi, it's Michelle from Lab Muffin Beauty Science, chemistry PhD, skincare nerd, and a bit of a mess. I don't know about you, but over the last year with lockdowns and working from home and general stress, my daily routine has just gone out the window. I keep losing track of when I last changed my sheets, when I should be eating lunch, when I should go to sleep. Some days I've even forgotten to shower until it's too late for me to shower. So a lot of nights I just haven't had the energy to do a proper full skincare routine. It's sort of like the last thing on my mind. And with mask wearing, my skin has needed more attention. I'm getting a lot of congestion around my chin, and I might be starting to develop a little bit of perioral dermatitis. So today I thought I'd talk about some skincare products that I found really helpful when I've just been too lazy to do a proper routine or when I have to play catch up with my skincare. Let me know what products you like using for this if you use the same products as me. If you like talking about the science behind beauty products, click the like, the subscribe, and the notification bell so you don't miss any videos. I'm going to start with today's video sponsor, and it's a product that I think a lot of you knew I was going to talk about for this, which is Bioderma's micellar water. I talk about this a lot, but analyzing an ingredients list is useful to an extent, but because products are so complex, you can't tell everything just from the ingredients list. That's why testing products on actual people, getting clinical evidence, is so valuable in getting science-based skincare. And that's why so many skincare experts, scientists, dermatologists, aestheticians, recommend Bioderma all the time. They are so thorough with their clinical testing. They collaborate with research institutes and dermatologists to create their products, and that means they end up with products that just work really well for a lot of people. I've raved about their micellar water before, and it's become such a staple for me over the last year. This is actually the world's first micellar water. It's the product that started the craze. It's a really gentle cleanser that's effective at removing dirt, oil, makeup, and pollution without disrupting the skin's barrier very much, and so that makes it really good for sensitive skin. In clinical testing, 97% of people with fragile or sensitive skin found they had a soothing effect from this cleanser. I've talked to so many dermatologists and makeup artists and people with sensitive skin who also rave about this. Now, not all micellar waters are formulated for sensitive skin, but this one has a number of features that makes it really good. It has a skin-friendly pH of 5.5 and it's fragrance-free, and it contains one single gentle surfactant. Now, I know we tend to think of surfactants as harsh, irritating ingredients, but it's actually a really broad category. Unlike a lot of rinse-off cleansers and other micellar waters on the market, this only has one super gentle, non-ionic surfactant ingredient. It's a skin-softening emollient moisturizer that can actually counteract irritation. The water they use is also special. It's highly purified injection-quality water. And in a lot of other cosmetic products, the water has endotoxins, which for most people is okay, but if you have very sensitive skin, it can be irritating. I love this cleanser. You can use it as the first step of a double cleansing routine, or I usually use it as a standalone cleanser. I use it with reusable cotton pads. Mine are from Bamboo Face, and I found that these are really gentle. I used to use it with cheap cotton pads, and I found that my skin was getting a bit sensitive, and that was actually because the cotton pad was rough. Once I switched to a softer pad, I found that I didn't have issues, so it was just the physical exfoliation from the cotton pad. So if I have makeup on, I'll probably use two cotton pads. If I don't have makeup, I'll just use one and then wipe it all over my face, then chuck this into the laundry. It also used to be my travel cleanser back when we were actually traveling. I've also started using this in the morning just as a morning cleanse. If you know my skincare routine, I used to just splash my face with water and then pat it off because my skin's really dehydration prone. But my skin's changed so much from wearing masks. After seeing a dermal clinician, which is what we call aestheticians in Australia, she suggested that maybe I should cleanse my face in the morning as well. Maybe that one cleanse in the evening wasn't quite enough. So I've just started doing this. I'll keep you updated on how that goes. So apart from the micellar water, which I think is my one big love from Bioderma, they have lots of other great products. I feel like everyone in my family is now using at least one Bioderma product. Another of my favorites is the sebum foaming gel cleanser, which is what I use a lot of the time when I do a proper cleanse. I've reviewed the sebum range before. It contains a bunch of actives that really help with pimples without drying out your skin. So it helps with pore clogging and oil, and the whole range works really well alongside traditional acne treatments. I also love the Atoderm range, especially in winter. It's great for dry skin, it's really good for strengthening your barrier and restoring lipids. The next product I'm talking about is Kate Somerville's Exfolicate. This is a rinse-off exfoliating product. I guess you could call it a peel or a mask. You're meant to leave it on for about 2 minutes, and this is my catch-up product for when I've forgotten to exfoliate. I use this a lot in the shower, and because it's rinse off, it fits in really easily with the rest of my routine. I don't have to worry about whether or not it's going to interact with something else or peel up. This is a chemical and physical and enzyme exfoliant, so it's got alpha hydroxy acid, it's got lactic acid, BHA, which is salicylic acid. It has tiny silica scrubbing granules, so you apply it by massaging it on for about 30 seconds, and then you leave it on after that for... You're meant to leave it on for a total of 2 minutes. I'm sure I've left it on for longer without problems. There's also three types of enzymes in this. It's got papaya, pumpkin, and pineapple enzymes. So it's basically ticked off every exfoliation category I regularly use, apart from maybe peeling gel and PHAs. Now, this is a bit expensive. It's a bit more bougie than I normally go for, but it lasts for ages. So I only use about a pencil eraser's worth every time, and I think in total, I think I'm on my second tube. They also recently launched a 15ml version, which is a bit more affordable, so it's great if you're not sure if you want to commit to a proper tube yet. I've tried some other peel products, but I always end up going back to this because it works really well. It has all three types of exfoliants, but it also just has a really great texture. It's a thick green paste and it stays on your skin really well. It doesn't drip down your face when you're in the shower with all the steam. A lot of other peel products are very liquid and very runny, so when I'm in the shower, I can feel it dripping down my face. This one does not. So I am still paranoid enough to keep it above my eyebrows, but yeah, I haven't really felt this running into my eyes yet, and I still have my eyes. Next, I have the Paulas Choice 0.3% retinol and 2% bakuchiol treatment. I really like this because it has this combination. Bakuchiol is a plant extract that helps with wrinkles and hyperpigmentation, and it's been marketed as like an alternative to retinol. It really isn't. It's not a retinoid. It doesn't work the same way, even though it has a similar overall effect, but so do a lot of other ingredients in skincare. But it is still a pretty promising ingredient. Now, according to Paulas Choice, the bakuchiol can help the retinol work more effectively. I don't know what evidence they have for this. I tried looking through their references, but they have a really awful referencing system, so I can't tell what paper they're talking about. Anyway, this is a really nice light lotion. Apart from the retinol and bakuchiol, there's also peptides and skin-soothing ingredients. And so that means we have a retinol product that isn't all that irritating, which means you don't have to be that careful with the application. Some nights I'm just too tired to carefully measure out a tiny bit of tretinoin, and I can't trust myself with that responsibility. Because it's got that combination of ingredients, I don't feel like I need to use extra products. And because my skin is more on the oily side, this works as my moisturizer as well. If your skin is a bit drier, then maybe that won't work. You might need an extra product. Along the same lines, this is Kate Ryan's Total Nutrition Night Repair Complex. I've raved about this product before. It's a very similar idea. It's an all-in-one product that just makes your skin look really nice the next day. It has a bit of everything. It's got niacinamide, retinol acetate, centella extract, and antioxidants. So this is really great for when I want my skin to look a bit nicer, but I also don't want to risk any sort of irritation, so the night before filming a video. Now, on nights when I feel a bit more capable of using Tret, I really love the Claire's Midnight Blue Calming Cream. This is really good for mixing with tretinoin, and it calms the skin down a bit, so if I go a little bit overboard on the Tret, then I'm a bit safer, and it also helps the tretinoin spread over skin much faster. So I just mix it on the palm of my hand with about a half pea size amount of tretinoin and then spread it all over. I've also been enjoying Glow Recipe's Lip Pop. So they're a skincare brand that have recently branched out and they've launched lip products and body products. They have a lot of fruit branding, so this smells delicious. It smells like watermelon. It's a really rich, soft, moisturizing lip balm, and it also doubles up as a lip scrub. It's got little sugar granules in it that dissolve over time and alpha hydroxy acids. And so I use this at night. It also has a little bit of a stain in it. I have the sort of coloring where I look a little bit dead if I don't have some sort of color on my face, especially on the lips. And so wearing this at night means that when I wake up in the morning, my lips are already sort of a little bit made up. And so if I just wake up 5 minutes before a Zoom call, I don't look too bad. I hope you liked the video. If you have any other product suggestions for me to incorporate into my lazy skincare toolkit, let me know. You can give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more videos like this. You can also follow me on Instagram and check out my blog for more of the science behind beauty products. See you next time to nerd out more.